Prospera raises $7 million in a Series A investment to use machine learning to monitor crops using cameras and sensors, problem-solving things like pests, disease, irrigation, and nutrient deficiencies. Farmers traditionally would do this manually by feeling it out with their fingers and feeling it out with their toes. Agriculture is all around them, and so the crop does grow. Welcome to Machine Learning in a Nutshell. I'm Mark Register. Startup Candid uses natural language processing to classify a post as negative or positive statement, then scores how strong it is. That sounds like a challenge. Gene Kogan creates the Cubist Mirror, turning your face into a work of art, like what Prisma does in real time, allowing anyone to be a real piece of work. Charlotte-Mecklenberg Police Department in North Carolina is working with the University of Chicago to identify potential risk factors of unprofessional conduct caused by stress from the job, so officers don't do something irrational after hitting a breaking point, like play basketball with the locals. NVIDIA releases their new Titan X card, which is 60% faster than their previous version at 12 gigs of memory, 3,584,000 cores at 1.53 gigahertz, and 11 teraflops of performance, further entrenching NVIDIA as the leader in machine learning hardware and pushing the limits of what we can do. Titan X's new slogan is "the intellectual's oversized pickup truck." Apple buys machine learning company Turi for $200 million, and Tim Cook explains machine learning is now driving Siri, iTunes, apps, and news. He says soon, instead of digging through apps, you'll have everything you need presented to you when the phone knows you want it, becoming a full-fledged assistant that can order coffee for you, and with your waterproof assistant abuse case, you can throw your coffee right back at it. Arjun Krishnan and his team are using the 65 out of up to 1,000 autism genes already identified to see how they connect with the other genes in the network and throw those patterns through a machine learning system using network-based evidence using a weighted disease gene classifier to identify the cellular pathways, creating a functional map of the brain. If you followed all that, have a cookie. You deserve it. Stanford's Computational Vision and Geometry Lab create Jack Robot, a mobile robot that understands implicit social conventions and human behavior, building an algorithm for social understanding. Jack Robot could be used for helping the blind, elderly, deliver medicine, be a guard, or act as a personal assistant. By predicting human behavior, it's able to maneuver and interact with crowds and individuals, allowing personal space for those who want it, making so much room to do activities. University of Oklahoma Health Science Center uses a skateboard, robot, and machine learning to help infants with cerebral palsy to build and reinforce spatial cognition and motor connections. The self-initiated prone progression crawler uses a cap with electrodes monitoring brain activity and movement, recording it, then processes it using a machine learning algorithm to guess what the infant is trying to do. Then the skateboard moves in the direction it thinks the infant wants to go, rewarding movement when otherwise infants with CP will give up without it. So yes, Steve Carell, if you don't use it, you lose it. Pat Inc., a company focused on natural language processing, raises $2.5 million in seed funding to combine neural networks with the linguistic role and reference grammar model developed by William Foley to identify how a sentence is formulated, picking up word meaning and context in larger bodies of text, describing it as how a five-year-old would process the information. Leading the way for his new game show, Is My Artificial Neural Network Smarter Than a Five-Year-Old? Bloomberg reports Richard Burke is coming out with an algorithm that will be able to determine how likely you are to commit a crime by your 18th birthday at birth. That's some Minority Report stuff going on. Burke previously worked with the Philly Probation and Parole Department in 2006 to help write a machine learning algorithm to identify which people were more likely to commit murder, then offer them cognitive behavioral therapy. In 2010, he came up with a high, medium, and low risk rating for people that judges in Pennsylvania and Maryland have been using for the last 5 years, affecting the outcome of parole rulings. Now, coming up with the right sentencing for the right person and crime is next for him. Race has been discarded as an input, but every other input they've been talking about is a sensitive subject as well, so it's a delicate subject picking the inputs to feed into the machine. Now, the most useful input currently is the success rate of curveball pokeball throws. Have a great week.